In this screencast, I'll show you how to do numerical integration in MATLAB. And as a bonus, we'll get a little bit of practice working with data from the NIST Chemical Webbook. Let's get started. Let's open up MATLAB first. Here we are. And let's write a script to calculate the work based on some data of compression. So we're going to compress some propane. So first we'll go to the editor and write our script. And when we do that, it's a good idea, go ahead and put some comments into your code so that you remember what each of your scripts is for, so that when you go back to them, if you want to use them for something else or adapt them, you'll be able to, it's easy to come back to your work if you've documented it. Okay, great. So we're gonna calculate the work done in propane when we're doing an isothermal compression at 298 Kelvin from 1 bar all the way up to 9 bar. And of course, we can estimate this using the ideal gas law, but it would be interesting to look at real data for a real gas and see how much different the answer is than just doing an estimate of the ideal gas law. So let's pull some real data from the NIST Chemical Webbook. Okay, so here we are at the NIST Chemical Webbook. So you can just get this by Googling NIST Webbook, and there's a wealth of data in here. It's an awesome site for physical chemistry. But at the very bottom, you see we have this thermophysical property for 74 fluids. And this is a great sort of sandbox to get data and look at real compounds and see what their thermodynamics are. So to get go to the webbook, we're going to click on this link. And that thermophysical properties is right down here. If we just wanted to know the heat of combustion or formation or whatnot for compounds or heat capacities, we would just go into this general window down here. But for what we're going to do now, we want to go down to this link here. So this is that list of all these different compounds and very detailed information or different temperatures and pressures for those compounds. So all we have to do is find propane in here, since that's the compound that we're interested in. So propane. And then we have to choose our units. Let's use Kelvin and bar. And liters per mole for our molar volume. And everything else is fine. Energy could be in kilojoules. We're not going to need that. And we want to do an isotherm. So we're looking at isothermal properties. Leave this as default for fluid. OK, we're ready to go. Say continue. And we said we wanted to do this at 298. And we wanted to go from 1 bar up to 9 bar. And we can make the increments as close together as we want. What is good at 0.1 bar increments, so it's not a huge data table. And we just press for data. And the default is to give you a graph showing you how the different properties change as a function of pressure. So we could actually look at how, for instance, how the entropy changes as a function of the volume. But what now we're interested in taking our data and analyzing it in MATLAB to get the work of when we compress this gas. So we want the actual data. So put it into an HTML table there. And that's something we can copy and paste. And just go ahead and copy the whole table. You can also download a tab delimited file if that's easier for you. So really either way is fine. Okay, so here we are in Excel. Let's paste our data. And really all we cared about, we know we're holding a temperature constant. We don't need that. But we do need pressure. So let's delete that. Let's keep the pressure. We do want the molar volume. So let's keep that. Let's get rid of all this other stuff. We don't need that right now. Okay, great. So notice we should pay attention to units because, of course, that's going to play out in what kind of units we get for our answer. So we're using liters per mole and bar for our volume and our pressure. Great. Now, the easiest way to get data into MATLAB is to save it as a comma separated values. And it's better to just get rid of the headers because then your first data point will be in the first row. So let's just get rid of this. And remember that pressure is first. And now we've got to save it. And let's save it as a comma separated values. And let's just call this propane data. Okay, and I'll just, oh, and we have to put that data someplace where MATLAB can find it, and the best place for that, unless you want to map a new path, is to put it into the MATLAB folder, which is your My Documents folder usually. So here we go, save, propane data, great. Okay, so now we've got our data in here. Remember, this is our pressure going from 1 bar to 9, and this is our molar volume going from 24 down to something much smaller at the higher pressure. Okay, great. Let's go over to MATLAB. All right, so let's write our script. So let's put in some clear stuff at the start. So if there's any junk in memory, we can get rid of it, and we can clear out down here our command window is going to be cleaned up if there's junk in there before. And let's put in our script. So first of all, we got to read in our data. So you got a comma separated values, read. So that statement tells MATLAB to go and look for some data, and you got to give it the file name. And the file name we're going to use is, it was propane data. Oops, put that in quotes there. Okay, so it's going to read that, and if we just want to make sure we did that one statement right, we could just run the script right now. Let's call this numerical integrate. Okay, and okay, so Rob, this is, I'm glad I made that mistake, because it actually needs the file extension or it won't work. So that's a common mistake to make. So I'm glad I made it. Now you won't make it. Okay, comma separated values. Let's run it. Okay, great. And we saw, so it put into MATLAB our pressure values and our volume values. If we don't want to echo that every time, we can just suppress the output by putting a semicolon there. Great. So we've got our data. Let's go ahead and put these into separate vectors that are labeled. So we'll say, the first one here is the pressure. So we say P is a vector. So what do you call it? We actually didn't put the data in a box. Let's put the data in a variable that we'll call data. Oops. Okay. Okay, and then let's split data into two different vectors, P and V, just so we keep track of the variables. So P is equal to the data, and we're going to go in and take all the rows, and we're going to take the first column. There's our P, and we'll do the same thing for V, all the rows, and this time the second column. Okay, so notice that if we do that, we're splitting out the data into two different vectors, one for our pressure variable, one for our volume variable. And if we wanted to, we could just remind ourselves what the units are so we don't make a units mistake later. So the volume was in liters per mole. And let's make that a little more obvious. And we said this is bar. Okay, great. So we've commented up our code. We want to actually do the integration. So the integration actually is just a single line, okay? And so it's going to use the trapezoid rule to numerically integrate this data. So if we wanted to, we could take the data and plot it and fit it to some function and integrate that function analytically, but we don't have to. Since this is numerical data, we can actually just integrate it by using the trapezoid rule. So you can see that it's telling us we want the x value first. So we're integrating p with respect to v. So v is our x. And P is our Y. And so we don't forget that this is just integrating. Okay, and let's run the code. So it tells us that we get integral is negative. And if we remember, this was supposed to do we have to remember this is a reversible isothermal compression. So because it's reversible, we know that the work is equal to the negative integral of P dV. And that means that if we take the negative of this, it's going to give us a positive number, which makes sense. We did work on the gas when we compressed it. And we have to be careful now. What are those units? Okay, so if we want to know what the units the answers in, we go back and look at the units for our input data. So of course, we want to convert this to joules at the end, and so we have to remember to do that and not leave this as 54. It's definitely not 54 joules, which is a mistake that the students would make. So do the conversion from liter bar to joules. Okay, great. So now you can integrate numerically in MATLAB.